Greetings, travelers, it is I, Sundae of Doom, here to wreak havoc upon all that are uninformed. And here we have the Origin Jumpworks M50, which is the only ship that's able to close its cockpit canopy when I leave it. Every other ship, the door just stays open. And it's not as crazy with its buggy thing, though. I bet you as soon as I lift off, it just what the flip me. So this is another racer from Origin Jumpworks. It is not as fast as a 350R, but it is a bit more, or has a smaller profile, still has massive engines on the back. Two supercharged TR2s, which, you know, it goes at like 280 meters per second, though. So that's not too shabby, especially from its. As the reason why is because it has this really light profile. I think the current weight is 12,000. The current weight is 12,000 kilograms. That's a check there. Comes with these M3As and one missile, bearing missile each. Size one bearing missile each on each wing here. Used to actually have. In the design documents, it actually had a little compartment underneath where the shield's stored underneath this thing. Can't show you here, but it's like a little compartment at the bottom here, and that's where the actual missiles were stored, as well as the shield, but I guess they realized it's kind of a little small, too small space to be fitting that in there. Has to be on the wings. So this is an interceptor. It's more of a racer, but it can be used as an interceptor, and it's quite ridiculously fast. Probably a pretty penny as well, but it looks good. Like, that does. Can I jump on here? Oh, guess not. Hey, nope. It has logos on the front too. Let's get in here. I just want to show you what it looks like in first person, because it's also really cool. Because it reminds me of getting into seeing drivers get into one of those F1 racers. Like, you can't really get, you have to squeeze your arms in. Oh, that's pretty awesome. Now, the cockpit, the canopy could use a little bit of cleaning. But it's very. As you can see, it's making everything look very dark. That's an issue with the texturing, I guess. So it goes pretty rapidly from 0 to 280. Oh, that sounds good. The cool thing about it is it's a bit more maneuverable than the 350R. The 350 is a little bit unwieldy, but this is so small that it has far less shaved off weight that it's a little bit easier to do turns without blacking out. Oh, I will black out at one point, I bet you. Or crash. Everything's okay still. It's a tough little mosquito, that's for sure. But it is quite cool. So you can think about using this as an interceptor if you have the money in game or in real life. But I guess I'm talking more about the PU. If you want to use this as interceptor, it might be a little costly if you get damaged. And when you get hit by something, you get hit. It's like getting a smart car getting hit by a truck or something like that. It's not pretty. But if you keep your speed up and you keep whizzing around everywhere and being very maneuverable and using evasive maneuvers to your advantage and your size profile as well as your speed, I think you can survive quite easily. Just it takes a far better piloting hand than I to not black out while doing that, especially when I have G mode off. So this is what G mode on would look like. Still fast, but It still blacks me out. That's not pretty. Stand by for information. Yeah. Look at this one, it's from the outside. Oh, blacked out. You can tell because I can't move anything. I'm stuck in one position. That's just so cool. It's kind of like seeing those planes in the Red Bull Challenge. These sometimes call it. Okay, I think I can do this. Can I thread the needle? Can Sundae do thread the needle? Yes, he can. Oh, he almost did it. Oh, it's quite a joy flying it, that's for sure. If you can't tell from my voice. Let's see if I can do any fancy flying around here. What? I think I went splat. I didn't feel like I hit anything, but I think I just literally went so fast that my guy just splattered all over the cockpit. Definitely hard to see through this through this fog that they decided to put onto the, like, we really need to get some anti-fog spray or something, as it's definitely not so good. Look at that smoke. Got an atmosphere leak. No. Okay. Oh, definitely is fun. That's for sure. So, that was a look at the Origin. And you see me blacked out right there. Oh, poor guy. I'm not meant for. I do the silliest things. You can see all those thrusters get out. Oh, look at those little thrusters. Sporadically firing. By the way, the thrusters on ships, it might look, it's not really real. I mean, it's real. They're planning on making it realistic, as in what it, the effect, the physical effects of it. But they, to make it more, to look a lot better, they made it so that instead of being sporadic, like if you looked at thrusters that are used in real life in space, they'd be shooting off every millisecond crazily, and it looked like a little bit like not as interesting, I believe, as what they were referring to. I'm not sure what it was. It's just, it has this kind of odd look to it that it doesn't look as clean and cool as seeing thrusters firing off like that. So what they did was it looks like it's just a continuous thrust, but it's actually not. That's just what it looks like. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed that, and it was informative enough to you, and later days, everybody. This is the Origin M50 series, or, well, there's no variants on it currently, but yeah, this is just the Origin Jumpworks M50, and it is a fantastic interceptor racer ship. Later days, everybody.